Graham, and they've worked hard. And we're so thankful for this opportunity we have to sing tonight about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the birth of our Savior. It wouldn't be Christmas without a Christmas program and fellowship with one another in the name of Christ. So in just a few minutes, we're gonna sing, and we're gonna start by asking Ben Ivy to come sing the Hallelujah Chorus, and that will open us up. And then following the Hallelujah Chorus, we will follow with the Christmas program. And after the program, there will be a time of response, and Brother Stanley will come with that opportunity this evening. And then after that, we would like for y'all to stay. We've got several refreshments in the back and that we prepared. So please stay with your friends and family as we have worshiped this together this evening and celebrate. So at this time, I'd like to ask Brother Stanley, if he would, to come lead us in a word of prayer. Technical error.
We're so glad to see you tonight. Glad you could be here to join in this time of worship to our Lord Jesus Christ as our choir presents O Holy Night. I'm so grateful for their hard work and their willingness to lead us in worship tonight. What a blessing to have folks who are willing to use the talents and gifts that God has given them to bless the Lord and to bless us. And so we'll be blessed tonight as we worship together. Let's bow as we pray. Father, we thank you tonight for your goodness and grace and for how you bless and work in our lives. Thank you for allowing us to be here tonight, to join in this time of worship as we hear the choir sing, as we see the actors from our children, Lord, and just for how they just present the gospel to us tonight. I pray, Father, that we would be open and receptive, responsive to your word tonight as you speak to us through this. And I just pray you'll use each one in a great and mighty way. Thank you for our guests that are here tonight. I pray that you'll bless each one greatly. And Father, as we do have this time again, we pray that your Holy Spirit would speak to us through this. And Father, that if there's anyone here lost tonight, we pray they'll come to know Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior. And that we as Christians will just worship you tonight in spirit and in truth the way you desire to be worshiped. We want to say tonight that we love you and praise you. Thank you, Father, again, for what our ears are about to hear and our hearts will experience. Bless Jacob as he leads tonight. We thank you for his hard work. And again, for this choir and all involved, Lord, may this please you. May it honor you. May it glorify your son, Jesus, is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Stay. The shepherds left their flocks by night to see. was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. This is the story of Emmanuel, God with us. Emmanuel, God loving us so much that he descended from heaven to be one of us. Emmanuel, God seeing a need so great that he emptied himself of his glory to rescue us. This is the story of Emmanuel, our Savior, Deliverer, Redeemer, the one God's people had watched and waited for so long, born on this holy night.
Ransom captive in this riot.
day when I shall raise up for David a righteous branch, and he will reign as king and act wisely and do justice and righteousness in the land. And this is his name by which he will be called, the Lord our righteousness. His plan for our salvation to pass. Just as he had spoken stars into existence, Jesus could have simply appeared. But 1 Corinthians explains that God chose the foolish things of the world to shame the wise, and he chose the weak things of the world to shame the strong. So in his wisdom, God chose a humble little Jewish girl to bring about the greatest miracle the world had ever known. Emmanuel would be knit together within her womb. The Creator would be created in human flesh and born as a baby. And as it always is with God's plans, He would do all the wonders it would take to make it happen if she would simply say, "Yes, Lord, I'm willing."
According to your word, I give myself.
Joseph was a good man. The news that Mary was going to have a baby turned his world upside down. Then came the dream. Joseph, don't be afraid. He must have repeated those words to himself over and over in the weeks and months that followed. What can we say about the night Jesus came that hasn't been said a million times? We retrace every step of the journey from Nazareth to Bethlehem. We picture Joseph's frantic search for a place for Jesus to be born. We try to imagine that first cry, but in the end, we're left without adequate words to describe this night of nights.
Bye.
first visitors who came to pay honor to the baby king were a bunch of slightly confused, still frightened shepherds. After being confronted with a sky full of angels, they wasted no time in finding Jesus. And when they did, it was clear that this baby was unlike any who had ever been born.
Oh,
On that holy night when Jesus was born, angels sang praises and shepherds worshipped. Before long, wealthy kings also found themselves at his feet. Ever since then, this is the choice God presents us with. Will we remain unaware of the Savior's arrival, or be unimpressed with his coming, or be unwilling to believe who he is? Or will we humbly bow before him and give him the honor and glory he alone deserves?
With me for a moment. I'm going to ask you just to bow your heads. Monty's going to come and play for us tonight as we have our time of response. I want us to think about what we've heard tonight, what our hearts have felt. The Bible tells us in John chapter 1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. John said, the Word became flesh, dwelt among us. We beheld His glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father. Jesus, God Himself, put on flesh. He was born in this world in a manger laid there by His parents, Mary and Joseph. God being His Father and Joseph being His adoptive father. Willing to come to this world and live a perfect sinless life and die on the cross for your sins and mine. God raised Him the third day. That's the gospel. The death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. But it came about because He came. He came to us in our time of need. He has done for us what we could not do for ourselves. He's offered God the perfect sacrifice. God accepted that sacrifice in pleasure. He accepted His Son and what He did for us on the cross, confirming that through the resurrection and the power that gives us life. Tonight we've heard about the coming, the first coming of Christ. We've seen it acted out by these dear children. It reminds us of the goodness and grace of God. It reminds us that we would be lost and without hope if it were not for Jesus. So as we have this time of response and invitation tonight, I just invite you to listen to God as He speaks to you through the Holy Spirit. As He draws you, as He convicts, as He shows us our need of Him. If you're lost tonight, if you've never trusted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I'm begging you tonight to listen to the Holy Spirit as He shows you your need of Him. Your need to repent and place your faith and trust in Jesus Christ. To turn from your old way of life and trust Jesus for the only way to life. And that is through faith in Him. The invitation is open. If you want to come forward and kneel and pray here at the altar, you're welcome to do so. I know we have many guests with us tonight, but we invite you to come as the Spirit of God leads you. We're here tonight to respond to the Lord and His calling. We want Him to be pleased with our response. So let's do so in faith. As Monty plays softly, if you need to come, I'll be glad to help you, pray with you, and show you God's Word. Whatever you need to do tonight, I pray that we'll be faithful to respond to Him. Don't leave tonight without Jesus in your heart. Don't leave tonight without forgiveness and a full pardon of your sin from the only one who can forgive you. His name is Jesus. Thank you so much for being here tonight and joining us in this time of worship. We're so glad that you're here, and I'm so thankful for how God's used this choir tonight and these young people. I think it would be appropriate to give the Lord a hand for the good work tonight that was done through this. I appreciate Jacob Cunningham and his leadership. To our choir and our church and all these young people who are willing to take part in this tonight, and Cindy and others who've directed them, I appreciate you so very much. And again, we're glad that you're here tonight for visiting. We're certainly honored that you've come to be a part of this service. And in just a few moments, we're going to dismiss and go to the fellowship hall and have a finger food fellowship. We'd love for you to stay and be a part of that. We've got plenty of food back there. We'd love for everyone to just stay and fellowship with us, spend a time with us to visit, and we would appreciate that and enjoy that very much. Jacob, anything else the choir wants to do before we dismiss tonight?
I think we can. We'll go ahead and do that. Okay. Turn me off before we sing.